The alkali metals. Group 1 elements apart from hydrogen are known as alkali metals. Now, hydrogen is unique. Let us talk about hydrogen first. Hydrogen as an atomic number 1 and electron arrangement 1. When you write the electron configuration of hydrogen, it is just 1. And let us draw the structure of hydrogen. It is just 1 proton, and then the first energy level is occupied by 1 electron. Remember ion formation in the previous chapter. Hydrogen can form hydrogen ion by losing 1 electron. It may also form another hydrogen ion which is negatively charged by gaining 1 electron. Therefore, when it loses 1 electron, hydrogen behaves as a group 1 element. But when it gains 1 electron to form the hydrogen anion, it behaves like a group 7 element. And therefore, hydrogen can either lose or gain an electron to form a stable configuration. And that is why we can also place hydrogen in this location. Now that you have known why we are not going to include hydrogen in the alkali metals, let us head to the alkali metals and start discussing more about them. The alkali metals include lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, and francium. As you can see, I have only written the electron arrangement of the first three members because we are going to be focusing on only the three members. For these ones, we are not going to deal with them for now. However, once we learn the characteristics of the first three, we could easily understand how the next three elements would behave. The first property we are going to discuss about the alkali metals is the gradation in size of atoms and ions. Atomic radius is the distance between the center of the nucleus of an atom and the outermost energy level occupied by an electron or electrons. Consider this. Let's say this is an atom, and this is the nucleus, which let's say has two neutrons and two protons. And therefore, we'll have the first energy level filled up with two electrons. So the distance from the center of the nucleus to the energy level that is occupied by the outermost electron or electrons is known as the atomic radius. Similarly, the ionic radius is the distance between the center of the nucleus of an ion and the outermost energy level occupied by an electron or electrons. Similarly, let us say we have an ion such as sodium ion. The distance from the center of the nucleus to the outermost energy level that is occupied by electrons will be the ionic radius. Now remember, the atomic radius and ionic radius simply mean almost the same thing. The only difference is that it depends with what radius you are measuring. Are you measuring the radius of an atom or that of an ion? However, the method of measuring it is the same. In the laboratory, it is not possible to measure the sizes of atoms and ions using simple laboratory apparatus. However, scientists have done numerous research and come up with standard ways of finding out the atomic and ionic radii of atoms and ions. Let us focus on the atomic radius. The atomic radius of atoms in group 1 increase down the group. As you can see in the diagram, lithium has a very small radius, followed by sodium and then potassium. This is because each alkali metal has one more occupied energy level than the previous member of the group. Look at the electronic configurations. For lithium, it has two energy levels because we just have the configuration 2-1. For sodium, it has the configuration 2-8-1, meaning it has three energy levels. And for potassium, it has four energy levels. Because of this, automatically, the atomic radius of the atoms in group 1 will increase down the group. How about the ionic radius? The ionic radius also increases down the group. For the same reason that there is an increase in the number of occupied energy levels as we move from lithium ion to potassium ion. Lithium ion has one occupied energy level. Sodium ion has two, while potassium ion has three. Moving on, how does the atomic radius of lithium compare to the atomic radius of lithium ion? Now, lithium forms lithium ion by losing one electron. In effect, the remaining electrons experience a greater nuclear attraction, meaning that the remaining energy levels move closer to the nucleus, resulting in a reduction in the radius, and therefore lithium ion has a smaller ionic radius compared to the atomic radius of lithium atom. Similarly, lithium atom has two occupied energy levels, while lithium ion has only one. This means that the ionic radius of lithium is less than the atomic radius of lithium. The same concept applies for sodium and potassium.